Hello students, today I am going to start the lesson Light, Reflection and Refraction. In this video, I am going to give a brief introduction of the lesson. Also, we will recapitulate the concepts which you have studied in your previous classes, such as laws of reflection and image formed by a plane mirror. Then you will learn about spherical mirrors. Also, you will understand and use few special terms related to spherical mirrors. Then you will understand the rules followed while drawing ray diagrams and representing the images formed by a concave mirror. Students, we can see the objects around us in the daylight, right? Can we see the same in a dark room at night? No, we can't. We can see the objects only when we switch on the light. That means we need light to see the world around us, isn't it? An object reflects light that falls on it. This reflected light, when received by our eyes, enables us to see things. There are many wonderful phenomena associated with light, such as image formation by mirrors, the twinkling of stars, the beautiful colors of a rainbow, bending of light by a medium, and so on. A study of the properties of light helps us to explore them. In this chapter, we shall study the phenomena of reflection and refraction of light. Also, we shall try to understand the reflection of light by spherical mirrors and refraction of light and their application in real life situations. Students, you have studied in your previous classes that light travels in a straight line. When light falls on a surface, following may happen: reflection, absorption, and refraction. First, we shall learn about reflection. A highly polished surface such as mirror reflects most of the light falling on it. Hope you are familiar with the laws of reflection of light. Let's recall them once. First law says, when light falls on a surface and gets reflected, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Second law states, the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal to the mirror at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. Students, you have studied about formation of image by a plane mirror in your previous classes. Now, let's recall the properties of the image formed. Image formed by a plane mirror is always virtual and erect. Virtual image looks like the image is inside the mirror and it is formed behind the mirror. This virtual image cannot be caught on a screen, whereas real images can be caught on the screen. Okay students, image formed by a plane mirror is always virtual and erect. The size of the image is equal to that of the object. Next, the image formed is as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Further, the image is laterally inverted. Laterally inverted means left and right of the object will get interchanged in the image. That means right becomes left and left becomes right in the image. These are the properties of image formed by a plane mirror. Have you observed how would the images be when the reflecting surfaces are curved? The most commonly used type of curved mirror is the spherical mirror. The reflecting surfaces of these mirrors are spherical. These are the part of a sphere. Here, this polished surface is the reflecting surface and this shaded side is the non-reflecting surface. The reflecting surface of a spherical mirror may be curved inwards or outwards. A spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is curved outwards is called a convex mirror. On the other hand, a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is curved inwards is called a concave mirror. These are the images formed by curved surfaces. Before we move further, let's try to recognize and understand few terms related to spherical mirrors. First, pole. The center of the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror, this point, is called pole. It lies on the surface of the mirror. The pole is represented by the letter P. Next, center of curvature. The reflecting surface of a spherical mirror forms a part of a sphere. This sphere has a center. This center is called the center of curvature of the spherical mirror. It is represented by the letter C. Students, note that the center of curvature is not a part of the mirror. It lies outside the surface of a mirror. You know that the spherical mirror is a part of a sphere. The radius of this sphere means the radius of the sphere of which the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror forms a part is called the radius of curvature. It is represented by the letter R. Here, this distance PC is the radius of curvature of this mirror. Next, principal axis. A straight line passing through the pole and the center of curvature of the spherical mirror is called the principal axis. Students, see this. Here, a number of rays parallel to the principal axis are falling on a concave mirror. Now see the reflected rays. They are all meeting at a point on the principal axis. This point is called the principal focus of the concave mirror. Similarly, observe the second figure. Here, the reflected rays appear to come from a point on the principal axis, which is behind the mirror. This point is called the principal focus of the convex mirror. The principal focus is represented by the letter capital F. Students, also see, when the light rays are reflected by a concave mirror, they converge at a point, means they meet, they intersect at a point. So concave mirror is called convergent mirror. On the other hand, when light rays fall on a convex mirror, the reflected rays will diverge, will spread. So convex mirror is called divergent mirror. So convex mirror is called divergent mirror. See here, this F is the principal focus of this concave mirror. Now, the distance between this principal focus and pole of a spherical mirror is called its focal length. It is represented by the letter small f. Here you can see this distance FP is the focal length of this mirror. Next, aperture. The diameter of the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror is called its aperture. See here in this figure, this distance mn represents the aperture of this mirror. In spherical mirrors of small apertures, that is, spherical mirrors in which aperture is less than the radius of curvature, here the radius of curvature is found to be twice of the focal length. We write it as r is equal to 2f. We can see that principal focus of the spherical mirror f lies midway between P and C. Now we shall study the formation of images by spherical mirrors by drawing ray diagrams. Consider an object placed in front of a spherical mirror. When light falls on the object and gets reflected, an infinite number of rays originate. To construct the ray diagrams, in order to locate the image, it is more convenient to consider only two rays. These rays are so chosen that it is easy to know their directions after reflection from the mirror. The intersection of at least two reflected rays gives the position of the image. First, let's represent the images formed by concave mirrors using ray diagrams. Students, there are four rules to be followed while drawing ray diagrams of concave mirror. If you understand these four rules here and follow them, you can easily draw any ray diagrams. Let me explain them one by one. First one, this is the incident ray, which is parallel to the principal axis. Let's see what happens after reflection. The reflected ray is passing through the principal focus of the mirror. So we can say that a ray parallel to the principal axis will pass through the principal focus after reflection. Second one, the incident ray is passing through the principal focus of the concave mirror. It got reflected and it is emerging parallel to the principal axis. So we can say that a ray passing through the principal focus of concave mirror will emerge parallel to principal axis after reflection. Third one, when the incident ray is passing through the center of curvature. It is passing through C. Let's see what happens now. It got reflected along the same path. Incident ray is passing through the center of curvature. The reflected ray is also passing through the center of curvature. That is, a ray of light passing through the center of curvature of a concave mirror is reflected back along the same path. Next, the fourth and the last rule is, see here, the incident ray is oblique to the principal axis. In this case, the ray will get reflected obliquely, making equal angle with the principal axis. We can say that a ray incident obliquely to the principal axis of a concave mirror is reflected obliquely, making equal angle. Students, remember that the incident rays and reflected rays follow the laws of reflection in all these cases. Okay students, that's all for today. In the next video, we shall learn to use these rules, draw the ray diagrams, and represent the images formed by concave mirrors. Now, try to answer these questions and check your understanding.
To watch more such videos, please. subscribe my channel.